Are we living today? It's your host, Zach SchuZ, Schumaker, and today we're going to be continuing this ESPN Top 100 breakdown for the class of 2021. Now, before going any further, make sure you hit the red subscribe button below, as well as like and comment this video, for I definitely appreciate that. Now, let's kick this off, though. At number 80, RJ Melendez. He's come from Puerto Rico, plays at Seton Point Christian, and he also won a state championship this year over an elite West Coast team. His recruitment is pretty open. He's kept it on the down low. A lot of offers from all over the place. You're getting a guy that might only be around 6'5", 6'6", range, but he seems to play a lot bigger than his height. That's that elite kind of level. That's what separates guys. He's athletic, can throw it down, can space out shoot the three real well. He's a guy that I really see developing and becoming a really elite college basketball player. Number 79 is Jaylen Blakes. This is a guy that has been a part of Team USA in different events. Blair Academy, been really the vocal point leader of this team for a couple years now. A floor general, a leader, a locker room presence. And a lot of people say Rutgers is kind of where he's getting some crystal balls too, but his recruiting is open and finally got him tied to the top 100, but he's going to continue to develop, and you'll see. He'll be a guy that transpired and become an elite, all-time great college player, whatever program he chooses. Number 78, Brandon Weston. Born out there in New York, a mecca basketball. Dominate. Goes out there to Chicago. That's where he makes his name for himself. Another mecca basketball. Comes to Arizona, West Coast basketball now, and I don't think nothing's going to change. This means that this guy is special. Just coming to Seton Hall, which is putting together one of the best classes in 2021. But what is Seton Hall getting in him? Well, he's going to throw it down from wherever on the court. He has that kind of that NBA bag. When you're talking about a guy that can just set up a guy, be able to pull up, step back, three, he's got that NBA-ready skill set. Overall, him playing the NBA is not in any kind of a question. I definitely see a guy like Grant Weston playing at the next level NBA. Number 77, Ahamad Bynum. This is a guy that I'm hearing has got a lot of G League interest. Honestly, would not be too shocked to see him possibly decommit from DePaul at some point, go G League. That shows what he is. And 77, that's not where he should be. We know Chicago players. We know how those guys produce at the NBA and college level. And y'all think he's going to be any different? No. He's a star in this 2021 class, not just in Chicago, but in the world. He has that dog mentality. He's going to go at that game trying to kill you every single play. He will break you down and go at you again and again and again until he gets what he wants. He will score at will. He will lock you up. There is nothing that separates this guy from getting a win and destroying whoever's opponent is. And that mentality is what separates a guy like Ahamad Bynum. That mentality is why if he goes to DePaul, you're getting a superstar. I promise you, he's only going to stay 1 year. He's a one-done player. But Ahamad Bynum is something special to behold. Number 76, Jaylon Tyson, Texas Tech commit. We know how Coach Beard can develop guys out there, and he's turning up big time. We saw him play at the AAU this past summer. When you talk about a guy that can shoot three at a high level, and this is his favorite move. He does a lot of the in and out, sidestep three. That's Jaylon Tyson's game. Also, he loves to catch and shoot three. He likes shooting in general. He also is very solid in the fast break. He will be a superb player for Coach Beard in his system. 75, Kaden Perry. A lot of people don't know who he is. You always see him in these rankings. Gonzaga commit. Been a committed for a little bit, but Kaden Perry is going to hold that thing down low. I'm looking at a comparison of guys like Jackson Hayes, Jared Allen, kind of that little undersized in terms of center position, a 6'9", 6'10 range, but extremely athletic, and he's stronger than both those guys I just mentioned. He's able to bang with a couple more guys out there, but he's a guy that you put him with Coach Mark Few, you're going to see Gonzaga run the conference and make a deep run the postseason, if not win it, with the core that they're bringing in right now. He's a guy that I love down low. 74, Luke Goode, Illinois commit. One of the superb best shooters, if not the best pure shooter in this entire 2021 recruiting class. Illinois built something special up there with each one of these years, getting guys that want to come back, pulling in the best of the best recruiting classes. Luke Goode is not going to separate that. He's going to spend 2, 3, 4 years out there and do his thing as a sharp shooter, elite player. And if he goes down as Illinois' all-time leading three-point shooter, not going to shock me one bit. 73, Julian Reese. Maryland commit, which Maryland also is putting together a special class out there. But what Julian Reese can bring is that center position, sure, but I expect a guy that can run a power forward. I think he could even develop into a small forward. He's 6'9", elite shot blocker, long, lengthy. I think over the next year or so, he's going to continue to develop. Now, if East Baldwin went out, he's going to take the next step, be the star player, face the team. I don't expect them to take any step back. I expect another state championship to occur for them. And I think that Julian Reese is a very, very, very special talent. Once again, down-to-earth player. I love what he's going to do. Coach Church is going to embrace him. And him spending 1 or 2 years, what I expect from at Maryland. Trey Kaufman, another guy that's really been rising up boards. He's not in a position where you got top five involving Purdue, North Carolina, Virginia, Indiana, and Indiana State. Whoever gets this guy, you're getting a guy I like to call Mr. Intangibles. You're looking at a guy that can do everything on the court. You want him to guard your best player? If that best player is a guard or a center or a forward, he's got you. If you want to be 20, 25, 30 points a game, he's got you. You want to be a slasher, cut to the basket, dunk on people, he's got you. Whatever you need from Trey Kaufman, he will do for you. He's Mr. Intangible. You know what that means? That means a guy that a college coach will fall in love with. But the end goal, the bigger goal for him, is the fact that he'll be playing at the NBA. Mr. Intangible, once again, NBA GMs love that. We see how valuable that is. He will be there eventually. My final guy I want to touch up on, 71, UConn commit, Samson Johnson. We're talking about a guy that can raise his bar to become an elite shot blocker, become an elite space-to-floor guy, and the power forward center position. UConn is putting together another spectacular class, rebuilding this program. Huge props to Coach Hurley. But you're looking at a guy that 6'10" range, long, lengthy, athletic. UConn is getting a steal in. Everybody needs to have in a top 75 or higher. I think by the time we look back at this in 5-10 years, where should he be ranked? Hit me a top 30 play because of the way he's going to develop over the next couple years. Does not shock me one bit. Well, I definitely appreciate all you guys for tuning in today. Can't wait to catch you on next episode of the breakdown the next group of players. And God bless.